I'm in the place where most of us do most of our praying. So this video is about how to pray on your own, how to have that as an everyday part of your life. I'm Zach with A Quest for Greatness. Most of you know the channel, but if you're new here, we are just trying to explain what it means to have a real relationship with God by looking at truth, by looking at the practical side of Christianity. How do I put this into use? And by dispelling myths that are held commonly about Christianity, faith, and God. If you are new to the channel, consider subscribing, hitting that button below. The notification bell will let you know when new content is released. And if this video helps any of you, please hit the like button, comment below. Hopefully this isn't the only time you pray. I know for some people it is, but that's what this video is about, is how to pray on a personal level. A lot of us struggle with that a lot more than maybe what you or I would think. But I think the first place to go and the easiest place to go would be Matthew chapter 6 if you want to know how to pray, because Jesus gives a model prayer in Matthew 6 in verses 9 through 13, in fact. And he says, pray then like this. Can I please just stress something for a second here, if you just bear with me? He says pray like this. He doesn't say pray this exactly. You ever seen like some sports teams? The coach would be cussing his face off and they all get together in a huddle and they say, our Heavenly Father, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, kind of mumble through it and all that kind of stuff. And you're like, yeah, what good did that do? Well, they literally think that you got to say that prayer. It's a model. So let's take some cues from that. Let's get some benefit from it. First of all, it starts with praising God, our Father who is in heaven, who in the ESV, hallowed be your name, praise God. Start by addressing him for who he is, lifting it up. You know, not only is it praising him and showing him how much you adore him and appreciate him, but it's setting the tone for your prayer, which, like life, does not need to be overly selfish. More about that as we go on. But he says in the next part, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So pray in praising God, and also pray bigger than you. Now, your problems that you need to pray about, my problems I need to pray about, and the things that I'm going through and the things I need to ask for aren't the biggest thing. The kingdom is the biggest. God's will being done is actually the biggest. And that's what Jesus is modeling here, is praying for something bigger than me. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Then he comes to this phrase, give us this day our daily bread. Ask. Yeah, James chapter 4 says, you don't have because you don't ask. And when you do ask, it's because it's so that you can spend it on the things that you want. You do it in a greedy sense, if you will. Go back and read that, James 4, 1 through 4. But ask for your needs, ask for the things that will help you and so forth. And we have the Spirit who intercedes for us when we don't know how to pray in Romans chapter 8. The next part, so we've got praise, right? We've got praying for what's bigger than us, God's will, his kingdom, asking for our needs. Then he says, and forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. Ask him for forgiveness. That's a constant. That's a way of life. Repentance, confession, both of those are a way of life, and they need to be brought up in prayer. He knows we need it, and we know we rely on him, but he still wants us to do it, and Jesus models it here. And also, it helps you to remember that phrase, as we have also forgiven our debtors. Remember that I'm involved in my forgiveness, meaning if I can't do this for other people, I shouldn't expect any of this from God. But ask for forgiveness. It helps remind us of what we need from God most of all, as well as other things. And then he finishes, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Ask for spiritual health. Make sure your prayers are not just about health. Your prayers aren't just about your physical needs. Ask for spiritual help, because that is your biggest problem and my biggest problem. So start with the model as a way of what to include in prayer. The only thing that's not included here, and it's mentioned plenty of other places, is Thanksgiving. I'll talk more about that in a minute. All right, so one way to do this as far as prayer is to have prayer time, specifically budgeted time allotted. Most of you already know, in a busy lifestyle like this, that as you budget your money, you need to budget your time. And there's got to be some time cut out, carved out for God. Jesus talks about that in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 6. Most of you know this, but he says, but when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. What about Daniel? Most of us know that, right? In Daniel chapter 6, the only way those guys who had so much against him could trip him up was to try to interrupt his spiritual life. In Daniel 6:10, he got the bad news that the king had signed this decree that nothing could be asked of anybody in authority besides the king. And so when Daniel knew that the document had been signed, he went to his house where he had windows in his upper chamber open toward Jerusalem. He got down on his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before his God as he had done previously. It was a habit for him. There are other ways to do this, but this is one way, and probably the most difficult way, is to carve out time. You know, you can do all kinds of things like pray in the shower, pray in your car on your drive to work. There's lots of places where you could just carve out some time for you and God. I just mentioned 2 things while you're doing something else. Even better than that is some time where you have nothing else to concentrate on but your prayers to God. Daniel did it. Jesus instructed us and did it himself as well. It's a good idea for you and me. Another aspect of praying is praying reactively. We've covered, you know, setting aside time, but praying reactively. This is one that I'm so grateful my wife taught me. I've said it before, I'll say it again, that I didn't know how good I had it. I didn't know what I was getting. I didn't even know what to look for. But God blessed me with a woman who taught me, even as we were dating, how to do this, how to pray reactively. I'll give you a couple of verses to give give more depth to it. But in the moment, to say thank you in the moment, to talk to God as I'm getting ready to show you about praying without ceasing. This is part of how you do it. I knew when we were dating after a while that if I drove by, we were together and we drove by an accident or we saw wings, you know, airlifting somebody to an ambulance, that I knew when she went quiet, she was praying in that moment. And she learned how to do that at school or wherever she was. And you and I can train ourselves to pray and react if there's a problem, to immediately pray about it. If there's somebody who asks for prayer, not to say I'll do it later, but in that moment, ask right then. For some, you see them on social media, you hear people asking, pray in that moment instead of saying I'll do it and you forget about it and feel guilty later on. But Luke 23:34 says, Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do, and they cast lots to divide his garments. In that moment, Jesus wanted forgiveness for those. They weren't going to get it necessarily, but that was in his mind, on his heart, as they say, and he prayed reactively to the people who are murdering him, saying, Father, forgive them. How about Jonah? Jonah chapter 2 and verse 1. How did he react when he's in the belly of this big fish that God had put him in? Then Jonah prayed to the Lord his God from the belly of the fish. In that moment, in that time of need, he goes to him immediately. That's another aspect of how to pray. All right, some tips. Practicality, right? Because if you don't know how to use it, what good is it? Some tips for praying. And look, some of these are opinionated. They may help you. You may have some others that you could actually leave in the comments and say, hey, I do this, that, and the other. It doesn't just help me, it's gonna help our community people that may read those comments. But for me anyway, never say amen in personal prayer. I know why, and I'm not gonna jump into the whole amen thing, but I don't know that I don't remember the last time I said amen in any personal prayer to God. And part of that is 1 Thessalonians 5:17, pray without ceasing, because it's always an open line of communication. It's not like having a phone conversation where you say hello and goodbye and that sort of thing. It's always, and it helps with some of these other points I've covered already. And another one is have a daily thank you prayer. You've heard me mention this in another video, but I'll say it again real quick. You don't want a relationship with somebody who's only gonna ask you for stuff every time you talk to them. None of us like that. I wonder how God feels if all I ever do is ask him for stuff every time I come to him. And another thing about a thank you prayer is it helps me to count my blessings. It keeps me from complaining. And it's a great way to start the day by what all you have to be thankful for. And it sets your mode. Another one is to find a place for just you and God time. You do that with your husband or wife. You do that with your children. With any significant relationship, you want to have some time just for the two of you. Do that with God as well. And remember that you're talking to, I guess this would be the fourth tip, remember that you're talking to your Father. How do I say that? The best way it works for me is I try to talk to him like a dad. I always respect him and I want to speak to him with respect, but I also want to be familiar with him. I mean, when we talk to our fathers, our dads at home or people we're close to, we're not so formal, you know what I'm saying? So have that familiarity there and the respect at the same time and find that balance. And then the last one I have down is to vent. Vent to God and read some Psalms. It will show you some venting there from David and others in the Psalm. But a lot of us struggle with gossip and talking too much, and really God is the one to share that with. And it's also sharing your life. When you go home in the evenings or whenever and you see people that you haven't seen all day, you share what's going on in the day and so forth. Try that with God. It may sound difficult. I know a guy who, and I haven't necessarily done this, at least in a long time, who would put a chair across from him and talk to that chair because it helped make it more real. So there's all kinds of little things like that. And I hope that helps you with your prayer life.